A few years ago, I made my second video for YouTube and posted it. The topic of this video was how to get Americium 241 out of smoke alarms. Although this was not my best video, in my defense, I was new to this whole YouTube thing. But I digress. So the purpose of this video is to right the wrongs from the video and to add all the information that I missed when I made the original. And to keep some people happy. Now let's start. The smoke alarm is a very common thing. In the United States, it's needed to be code compliant in any occupied structure. It is also one of the more common, if not most common, item that contains a radioactive material. This radioactive material is known as americium-241, a synthetic isotope. Americium-241 is a common byproduct in nuclear reactors, not made directly from uranium, but from plutonium. It is important to note that not all alarms are ionizing alarms, i.e. the ones that contain the radioactive material. Some are photoelectric. These do not contain any americium. Both work in the same concept. Smoke enters, stopping something. Let's first start with the non-nuclear option. Photoelectric alarms work by having a beam of light or IR that is picked up by a detector. When this beam is broken, in the case of smoke entering the alarm starts alarming. This is the same concept in an ionizing alarm, with a few tweaks. In the ionization alarm, two plates have an electrical potential applied to them, but due to the air gap between them, the electricity is unable to flow. This is where the americium-241 steps in. Americium-241 produces, via radioactive decay, a particle known as alpha radiation. This is just helium without any electrons. This alpha particle is very good at removing electrons from the air. This process of removal of electrons is ionization. Through this ionization, electricity can flow on the ionized air produced, allowing the air to be conductive. This completes the circuit. Now, let's say smoke enters in the way of the americium source and stops the air from being ionized, breaking the circuit, tripping the alarm. Now let's go back to why the smoke stops the ionization. The smoke is being a shield and stops the radiation. Alpha particles are very easy to stop. As I said before, they are just helium atoms without electrons. Now that compare that to any other size of radiation, alpha is extremely large, making the chance of it interacting with another atom and losing its energy a very common occurrence. This just all comes together to mean that alpha is a very weak form of radiation, whereas gamma and beta are much stronger. This just means that alpha is quite safe to use in smoke alarms, as almost none of it escapes outside the device. Now, let's open one up. Of course, I need to start with a warning. Do not attempt anything shown. This is for educational purposes only, and do not dismantle or remove smoke alarms from anywhere. Now, you need to first make sure that the device you have is an ionization detector. As 90% of all alarms are, the one that you have will most likely be one. It says somewhere on the packaging that it contains radioactive material. Some are more prompt with this information. The other ones you have to look through the text a bit, but the warning is there. The most generic alarm I could find. This is the most generic alarm I could find, so the steps will mostly be the same for most of them. After opening up the package, there might be a few screws, but in this case, since it was so cheaply made and simple, you can just open it up. The AM241 is located in an enclosure, this one right here. Notice how it has the hazard symbols on it. Normally this is soldered on, but in this case, there are little folds that bend in. Let me grab a pair of pliers and push those in. Once they're pushed in, we can pull the top off. On this one, I'm going to cut this little piece right here, which keeps it on, and it comes right off. And there's our button, a little button of americium-241. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. If you need a place to talk science or just hang out, check out my Discord server. There are many like-minded individuals there, and we'd love to hear from you. If you want to see the continuation of this series, consider subscribing. Each episode will get better and better as I get more experience. Have any questions or anything to say? Drop in the comments section below. I love hearing from viewers. It's my favorite part.
Well, I don't know, but I've been told uranium ore's worth more than gold. So McCad, I bought me a Jeep. I got that bug and I can't sleep.
Uranium fever has gone and got me down. Uranium fever.